Sally Ann is the Salvation Army's fair trade business. This shop's in Dhaka, in Bangladesh. They sell a range of handcrafted goods, fabrics, gifts, clothing, and accessories. And behind each one, there's a story. The population of Bangladesh is growing, and it's the urban areas that have seen the biggest increases. The cities draw people from the countryside, most of whom are simply escaping the poverty of their rural villages. But the cities are overcrowded, work is scarce, and prosperity is often just a dream. For a few, the city will be a trap. This is Hatkola Road in Jeshur, a city in southwest Bangladesh. There are three brothels on this road, and over 250 sex workers live here. Once they're here, most won't leave. Some were tricked by the promise of a respectable job. Others were taken against their will and sold by crooks. The brothel's where they work, but it's also their only shelter. It's where they eat, sleep, and bring up their children. In 1997, the Salvation Army decided to do something. So they rented this small office space directly opposite the brothels.
Here in Jeshur, we provide health care and counselling support to the women working in the brothels. When we first came, no one was doing anything for them. They were getting no help at all. The government was supposed to provide these services, but in reality, it was the Salvation Army that actually got the work started.
Rani and Meena both work for the Salvation Army, and as part of their work, they visit the brothels every day. They're well known here, and over the years, they've built up a good level of trust. There are significant health risks to the women here. Even though HIV and AIDS are still relatively scarce, levels of other sexually transmitted infections are very high, and the women often experience violence and abuse. So when they visit the brothels, Rani and Meena try to pick up on health issues. They listen and offer advice.
None of these women ever comes to the brothel out of choice. Many of them are forced. Some can't see any other alternative. None of them wants to be here. And if there was any way out of this hell, they would take it. But they can't, because they've been forced into debt, or they're threatened.
Mukta is pregnant. Her baby's due any time. But being pregnant has meant she hasn't been able to work for a while. And without an income, she can't pay the rent on her room or her protection money. The Salvation Army's always tried to help the women leave the brothel. It's proved very difficult because most of them, like Mukta, are heavily in debt and would be risking their lives if they tried to escape. But they're not giving up. Meena is now a Salvationist, but knows firsthand how difficult life here can be.
I was 10 years old. I came to Jeshur with my uncle on the way to India. But we lost each other, and I was trapped by a man who sold me to the brothel. I tried to escape, and I got as far as the temple, but I didn't know the roads, and then I was caught and brought back. They knocked my front teeth out, and then they tortured me.
She was in the brothel for 18 years. Then she met some Salvation Army workers. They helped her to leave. And since then, she's trained as a social worker.
I find it difficult to find the words to say how much better things have become. There are bad things in my past, but I've left that behind. Things are so good now, so good. God has kept me well.
A few miles out of the city is a Salvation Army craft-making group. Most of the women are Salvationists from the local corps, and they're producing crafts to sell through Salian. The baskets they're making today are sent to Dhaka, and from there they're exported to Salian shops. The money they get for the work gives extra income to these women who'd otherwise be struggling to make ends meet. As Salian became more popular, the business grew, and more women from the rural areas were helped. Then a connection was made. If the women from the brothels were trained to make Salian products, it would give them an alternative income. And for some, it might be the way to a new life outside the brothels. Back in the city, women from the brothels who now make Salian products have a team meeting. They've embraced the idea, but they weren't always so keen.
At the start, they had no confidence and they didn't trust us. But then things changed. We pay proper wages for the work done, and they realized they could earn money in a different way to help their family.
The Salvation Army has bought sewing machines, and the women now make a variety of craft products. These days, Meena spends a lot of her time helping the women.
I can now help others. I pray that I can help these girls come out of the brothel. I want to find work for them. This is my greatest ambition.
Salian has also been a way to help vulnerable women to steer clear of prostitution. Shaborna is 17. She was born in one of the brothels, and her mother still works there, but Shaborna never has. In the past few months, her mum's become ill, so Shaborna is feeling the pressure to find more money.
My mum is sick, and we have not been able to pay for her treatment. Our situation was getting worse, but the Salvation Army have helped me. Now I can earn some money, I can begin my higher education, and we can overcome our financial problems.
The Salian workforce began to increase as the range of products broadened and the work spread. This is a Salian workshop in Dhaka. All the women here have left the brothels. Shahina is 22.
Life was bad in the brothel. I got more money, but I was unhappy. I had no peace. Now I have happiness. I've learnt how to make craft. I've learnt to read and write. I've learnt all kinds of things, even how to talk properly. I've learnt everything from here.
The women are given fair trade rates for the work they do, and for a part of the working day they are given lessons in reading and writing. They're also given skills training, support and advice. The Salian range, which is all fair trade, is not only produced in Bangladesh. A growing number of countries around the world is joining in. The goods are packed and distributed to Salian shops. Rani is 18. She's worked in a brothel for 2 years.
I had no choice. We had no money. We were very, very poor. I had to go there. Now I have a job with the Salvation Army and I've married a good man. My life has changed.